Welcome everyone, and thank you for joining me for demo of Voxly, backlog prioritization app for Jira Cloud, one of the biggest prioritization apps in the Atlassian ecosystem. The main idea of Voxly is to help you standardize your prioritization process and help you decide what's the most important task to work on next as effectively and efficiently as possible. Usually, product and project managers, or managers in general, have trouble deciding on what to work on next while balancing all contributing factors they know about the project and tasks themselves, as well as trying to manage and collect stakeholders' feedback. It's especially hard to manage feedback from multiple stakeholders and specifically from different departments and include them in your prioritization process without spending too much time on meetings. In Voxly, you can prioritize anything, be it product backlog and roadmap, or project scope, project initiatives, risks or requirement in project management. You can also prioritize marketing campaigns, ideas, experiments, or backlog of content. So let's have a look at Voxly. First things first, after you install the app from the Atlassian Marketplace, you can find Voxly in your project navigation menu under the tabs called Priorities. When you access the Priority tab, you will be able to see this table where you can find all your issues from the Jira project that you are currently in. In the table, you can see the metrics and the priority score columns. Voxly works on a simple principle of voting on each metric or factor, if you like, for each issue. Once all metrics are assigned for the issue, the priority score is automatically calculated. The metric and score calculation is completely customizable. When you come to the app for the first time, the ICE prioritization method will be preselected with impact, confidence, and effort metrics. You can always change your prioritization template or customize it here. In order to get the right view in this table, you can use filters here on the top where you can filter either by project if you would like to prioritize issues from multiple projects at once and to do a cross-project prioritization, but you can also filter by additional fields like, for example, fixed version, status, issue type, assignee component, and so on. There is also an option to use the Jira saved filters if you would like to save the views and quickly switch between them, or you can also use this JQL search for a little bit more advanced queries. If you would like to customize this table view a little bit further, you can also pull additional columns to the view. You can pull any field from Jira, like for example, project, which is handy if you are doing a cross-project prioritization, but you can also show the assignee, components, fixed versions, and so on. This way, you get additional information that might be helpful while you are prioritizing, and you can see everything in one view. There's also an option to prioritize your issues and see the priority score and metrics from the Jira issue detail itself, so you won't need to necessarily access Voxly Priorities table when you need to change the score. Priority score also saves in a custom field that is called Priority Score, so you can work with this field in Jira. You can filter by it or create dashboards using the data from this field. You can also pull this information to your backlog or your Kanban board to show values from this field. This way you can quickly see what priority score each of your tasks has. Or you can order your backlog by priority score. Now let's have a look at the prioritization method customization options. So you can see what kind of prioritization methods are available and how you can change them to better suit your needs. Here you can either select one of the predefined prioritization methods that are in Voxly, like for example RISE, ICE, weighted shortest job first, value versus effort, or quick wins method. You can learn a little bit more about each of these methods in our articles, but just to quickly recap, the ICE method is great for prioritizing experiments or any marketing tactics, but it's also good for product backlog prioritization if you don't have usage data available and you don't have insight into how much your customers are using your product. If you do have this insight, then it's better for the product management to use RISE method, where you can also consider the reach metric in your process. So you can define how many customers is this feature or improvement going to reach if you're going to deliver it, which is a great metric to have. The weighted shortest job first method is typical for larger organizations that are using SAFe, as well as smaller organizations for project management. The value versus effort method is very simple. It just uses two metrics, which are value and effort. So if you're just getting started with prioritization and you're looking for something very simple, you can go ahead and use this method. And finally, the quick wins method is the experimental one created by us at Jigsaw, and it helps you identify the quick wins and avoid the quick wins toxicity while prioritizing. In terms of customization, you can customize your scoring formula by simply adding additional metrics or changing them. In terms of customization for the metrics, you can change either value or the name of each metric. The value is the number that Foxly uses to calculate the priority score, and the label is what's shown in the table to make prioritization easier for everyone. For example, instead of assigning numbers when assessing effort metric, you can use t-shirt size estimation instead, using labels like S, M, L, and so on. And there are also different formats for your metrics that you can choose from, like label format, which uses the color. There's a short text metric using only text options, and there is a number metric that accepts only number input, and also a rating option, which gives you 5 stars rating for your metrics. So you can choose any of these while creating your new metric or a new factor in your prioritization. And you can always adjust the values to tweak your priority score. Once you finish customizing your template, you can either save changes as a new template, which creates a new template that is used in this project, or you can save changes to all projects that use this template so you can distribute the update faster. There is also a checkbox to save your metrics as a custom field. This custom field option allows you to create a custom field in Jira with the data from these metrics and work with them further in Jira. For example, with automation for Jira to automate parts of your prioritization process or export them to a CSV or Excel and so on. When using this option, just remember that it creates 2 custom fields, one for the label and one for the value. So you can choose which one you want to work with. For example, if you want to add this custom field to your Jira Create Issue form or to your form in Jira Service Desk, you can use the label field because it shows you the dropdown with an options that you can select from. Now, when you customized and selected your prioritization method, you can prioritize your issues in Foxly. And afterwards, you can either order this priority table by a priority score from the highest to lowest to see the most impactful issues on the top. You can also order by the metrics if you would like to see, for example, the easiest ones on the top or the ones with the higher impact. But there's also an option to use the priority matrix to help you visualize your priorities in different priority quadrants. You can customize the priority matrix to your own needs. There is an option to select the metrics for the X and Y axis, but also for the bubble size. So you can, for example, select the effort on the x-axis and impact on the y-axis, and then you can identify the high impact and low effort quadrant where you typically find quick wins. There is also a quadrant with a low impact and high effort, which is usually for the issues that are recommended to be postponed or skipped. If this view gets a little bit busy for large backlogs, you can either use filters on the top or you can use this table view. When you scroll down under this chart, you can see all the issues that are in this particular quadrant, and you can open issues in Jira Navigator to do additional filtering, bulk actions, or export them. Now, there is one big part of the app that allows you to democratize your prioritization process a little bit more, and it's especially useful if you are involving a lot of people in your prioritization process. It will help you shorten your backlog refinement and prioritization meetings either with your team or with your stakeholders. And this tool is called Priority Planning Poker. The principle of Priority Planning Poker is really simple. You basically select issues that you would like to prioritize and then select the metrics that you want to focus on during the meeting. For example, if you are prioritizing with your business team or with your stakeholders, you want to select metrics like impact or reach. But if you're prioritizing with your delivery team, you might want to select metrics like effort or confidence or any additional team-related metrics that you might have. So you can create 2 different prioritization poker sessions for different teams and the different meetings to keep everyone focused. After you create your planning poker game, you can invite others via link. You can either add a poker game to your calendar invite or send a message on Slack, Teams, email, or any of your preferred communication platforms in your company. And then once everyone is ready, they can join the poker and start voting on the priorities together. And don't worry, others can show you even after you started the session. The important thing to mention is that the planning poker is online. Everyone needs to vote together on each issue and basically play poker together. This is ideal if you are sitting together on, for example, Zoom call and you're prioritizing and then discussing the results. So let's have a look at what you can see here in the poker screen. On the side, you can find the issues that you selected to be prioritized, the ones that are ready to be prioritized, and the ones that are already done. Here on the top, you can find the issue that is currently selected for prioritization, and you can click to see more details about the issue description, comments, and fields. Here you can see the people who entered the poker session and who are still voting, who already voted, or who skipped the vote. And on the bottom, you can see the sections where you select and submit your votes. Once you submit your vote, wait for others to submit their votes as well. If you are the one who created the session, you're a poker admin and you can reveal the score when ready. When you reveal the score, you can see the distribution of the votes and who voted how, but also the average result of the vote, and you can discuss the results with your team, see if there are any outliers, and if there's any discussion or clarification needed. And if everyone is aligned, you can just move on. There's an option to also change the metric vote if you would like, and once everyone is happy with the metrics, you can accept the result and move on to the next issue. And like this, you can prioritize the whole backlog. Once you finish, you can go back to your backlog and you can order your backlog by priority score to see the most important tasks on the top and to see the results of the game that you just played. Now, before I finish the demo, let's quickly talk about permissions in the app. There are three permissions available in Foxly, one global permission and two on the project level. The global permission is the Administer Foxly permission that allows you to customize prioritization templates in all projects, vote on metrics, and run poker games. On the other hand, project level permissions allows you to only edit or view Foxly in the project where they are applied. Foxly also works with Jira issue permissions to make sure that no issues that user doesn't have access aren't visible to them. And you can read more about permissions in Foxly and how to set them up in our documentation on wiki.jaxa.io. And that's about it for the demo. Usually we also do get questions about security of our applications and pricing, so let me quickly answer your potential questions around that. Foxly is part of all Atlassian Marketplace security programs, including Cloud Fortified, Bug Bounty Program, Cloud Application Security Program, and Security Self-Assessment Program, including KaiQ Lite. As part of these programs, Foxly is being tested on a daily basis by independent security researchers to make sure there aren't any security vulnerabilities in our application. We also run the regular automated checks on our apps to ensure they are up and running, and we have a 24-hour SLA policy on our support, but we usually do reply in less than 4 hours. Foxly doesn't store any personal information. The only contact to your organization is the registered technical contact that gets updates about our app. In terms of pricing, Foxly is a Jira app paid via Atlassian. It comes with at least 30 days free trial, and after that you will be billed for the app together with your Atlassian tools bill. And depending on how you pay for your Jira, you would also pay for Foxly, either monthly or yearly. And the app is paid for all users in your Jira. So to make sure that the bill isn't as high, the more users you have, the price per seat decreases. The app is also free for up to 10 users, so if you are a small company or you want to test the app in your own test environment, you can use it for as long as you need for free. And that's about it. I hope that you enjoyed this demo of Foxly Backlog Prioritization app for Jira Cloud. If you do have any questions, you can always reach out to our support or check our documentation on wiki.jaxa.io. Have a great day and happy prioritizing!